We're on our way to Fully Charged Live 2023, and Diara's here as well. Say hello.
Hello.
Yeah, and we're going to mostly be looking at the home energy items, so things like heat pumps, batteries, other heating systems, that sort of stuff, rather than the cars. So last year when we came, Diara was looking at getting a heat pump, and we were doing a bit of research about that, but this year it's my turn, so I'm going to see how things have changed and what's on offer. So let's see you in there.
Do you use what three words?
No, I don't like what three words, because we've got a perfectly good positioning system called GPS, and that already works.
I guess the advantage of what three words is you can get the specific location down to 1 meter, don't
you? But you can get the specific location using GPS down to like a meter, and you don't have to pay another company licensing to use their proprietary product.
True.
Turned off the main route and out going down some very leafy lane. So we're parked up now, and the thing you'll notice about this particular event is pretty much everybody is an electric car. I mean, it's just, I'm in a massive field of electric cars. It's Tesla, 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 Cupra, Tesla, massive Range Rover that's definitely not electric, Tesla, 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 Tesla. I've just spoken to someone at Octopus, and they've taken my details to call me back on Tuesday about getting a heat pump installed. They're going to do a survey of the house, and they take £500 deposit, which is refundable even if I choose not to go with them. And they're going to install a Daikin heat pump, is the model they've chosen. I'll put that overlay of that on screen now. And it's the 9 kilowatt model this is, which is probably the same size that I'll need in my house. Come to a heat pump stand, and I found out it's pronounced Daikin. I had to ask. I wasn't sure if it was Daikin or Daikin, but it is definitely Daikin, and it's a Japanese company. So these are the heat pumps that Octopus Energy and, by the looks of it, British Gas and a lot of other companies seem to be installing by choice. There is smart control. Not sure it works with Home Assistant natively. Might need a bit of a fodge to get it working, but we'll certainly, these seem to be one of the most popular brands around at the moment. Now, the main alternative to Daikin is Vaillant, and I'm at the Vaillant stand. Oh, I can't fit it in. There we go. You see the logo up there now. And the reason I quite like Vaillant when I was doing my research was because it natively supports Home Assistant. You can actually get an integration through hacks and control the Vaillant heating system. I forget the name of it at the moment, but they've got like a smart control system, and you don't get that with Daikin as far as I can find. But Vaillant don't appear to have been chosen by all the energy companies to actually supply them, so there must be a reason that Daikin have been chosen. I'm guessing it might be cost, but we'll never know for certain. Changed my mind on Vaillant. I've just been inside this stand, and they've got a hydrogen boiler. So have a look at that. I'm not convinced hydrogen boilers are a safe or sensible thing to be investing in. So I think if Daikin are just concentrating on heat pumps and electric heating, then I think they're probably more sensible choice. Come to the GivEnergy stand now, and they've got the all-in-one on display here. It's got like up to seven kilowatts of power from the inverter and 13 kilowatt battery. It's basically, if you've seen the Tesla Powerwall, it's like the Tesla Powerwall, but you can actually control it. You don't have to rely on the AI software, so you can actually tell it when you want it to supply your house, whether you want to store a bit more energy now or use it later, so you don't have to rely on it to learn. On the other wall over there, we've got the car charger, which is kind of like been coming for a long time. I know a lot of people really want that car charger because it should integrate nicely. If you've got a GivEnergy system, it'll integrate really nicely with your battery, so you'll be able to prioritize whether you're using your charging your car or charging your battery, so that should be quite good. I'm at the myenergi stand now, and I've come to look at their battery, and they've apparently got the Libbi now, which is basically the K-Star rebadged I've got the eddy installed in my house, and obviously the hub and the RV that goes with it. So let's take a look at what new things they've got on offer.
It's really busy on this stand, where I can just about get a shot of the Libbi. And what I want to do is zoom in on the little box above, which is like a gateway. That's the proprietary myenergi part, I think, that links the whole battery into their app and their ecosystem. If I zoom out. I'm in the British Gas Hive section now. This is really for my dad, because he's got the British Gas system. He uses Hive, and he's got a couple of radiator valves, the thermostatic radiator valves, and the Hive home hub. I know it works well, and he can use it because he's in his 60s. So if he can use it and he finds it easy to use, he's even got like a motion sensor and stuff. So he quite likes it. So it works well for him as a very simple home automation solution and a heating automation solution. British Gas have also got the Daikin. They've got the heat pump on display here as well, and it's working. It's a nice cool breeze coming off it, which I think is a good thing. But this is the 9 kilowatt model as well. So it looks like this is quite a popular model that's going to be rolled out across the UK soon. Just coming to look at Herschel now, and regular viewers will know that I'm a bit of a fan of the infrared radiators, because I've got one sitting under my desk at home. But Diara is a bit more skeptical about them. They're brilliant. This is the towel rail, and this is what I think I might be putting in our ensuite. And we're here at Herschel's competitor Jigsaw, and I've just noticed they now do standalone portable heaters as well. Here's their smaller portable heater, which is kind of a competitor to the little under desk one that I've got. It's a little bit too big to fit under my desk, I think, but they have got quite a compelling smart solution to go with them. I don't know whether this one is smart or not. I'll have a look. The portable one doesn't look smart to me. I think it's just a remote control using a normal standard remote control. So I think Herschel have still got the edge with that one there a little bit. Here's a company I've not heard of before, SAJ, Smart Energy Storage. And they've got a battery solution. It's a stackable battery system. Each battery is 5 kilowatt hours, and you can stack four of them, take up to 20 kilowatt hours if you wanted. I have the leaflet right here, and obviously it's a hybrid inverter, so it can do your solar as well. This one here is 5 kilowatts, but they go up to 12 kilowatts if you needed a more powerful one. So here is the Mixergy smart hot water cylinder, which has got lots of clever little gadgets bolted to it to help mix the hot and cold water together to stop as it stratification, and supposed to be quite efficient compared to just having a normal hot water tank. So yeah, I didn't want to say in front of the Mixergy guys, but I'm not convinced by the product personally. I think it's quite a complex solution to storing hot water. I think it costs quite a bit of money, and you have to get it serviced every year, and I don't see what's wrong with a much cheaper, just normal hot water tank that is really well insulated and heated from your heat pump. So I think that's probably what I'm going to go with, because it's a bit of a simpler solution, less to go wrong, no maintenance costs on that at all. So, I wish them all the best. It's a really awesome gadget. I just don't think it's for me. So this is the Ivie Bud, and it's like an alternative in-home display, and they've actually updated it recently. They've now got a car charger they've bought out, and it integrates straight into the display, so you can boost your car charge from here and keep track of how much energy you're using. So it's quite a neat feature, which is unique, because previously I didn't really think much of the Ivie Bud, but at least that's a new feature that makes it stand out from the crowd a little bit now. I found the Ripple stand. This is the wind farm ownership, so you can be part of a co-op and own your own wind farm. I'm quite excited because I'm part of the wind farm that's Kirk Hill up in Scotland. And last week I actually signed up for some shares in the new solar farm, which is down in Cornwall, I think it is Cornwall or Devon. But I'm quite excited about that. That's coming end of next year for the solar farm. But the wind farm should be up and running by the end of this year. that this is the only electric car I'm going to be showing you in this video, and it's because it's the one that I really want more than any other. It's the VW ID Buzz, and it's basically the Volkswagen camper van. Well, not the camper van, this is like, it's almost like a seven-seater car. And I think they're going to produce camper van versions in the future, but I just think it's awesome looking. Can't fit it all in shot, but unfortunately it's really, really expensive. I think it's like starting at 50 grand, but hopefully they come down in price. I got a tip off when I was looking at the other ID Buzz to say that there was a converted one here already. So this is being converted by like a third party company. And here it is. So I'm gonna see if I can sneak past the crowds to have a quick look inside. That's me done for the day. Quite tired after all the walking around. I hope you found this video useful, and if you did, then please give it a like and don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see more videos from me. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.